spirit of the One Minute Play Festival. And tonight you're gonna see 60, almost 60 brand new One Minute Plays written by almost 30 Alaskan playwrights, staged by 7 amazing directors, and performed by a company of over 30. Now you can clap, that's the thing. We are a national organization. We partner with playwright, community, and education-specific theaters all around the country. We invite playwrights living and working in different communities into our playmaking process. We don't really tell them what to write about, but we give them a prompt that asks them to sort of consider the world around them, consider their communities, and the ways in which they view and engage the world, and they submit these moments to us. And when they do, we look at the emerging themes and ideas and styles and trends that sort of bubble up to the surface. We find those connections and try to like encapsulate them and reflect them back. So this is our way of sort of performing like a community mind map, where we use the image of a core sample sort of going into the earth and looking at a cross section of the dirt and seeing what's there. So we are here for a second year partnering with the amazing Perseverance Theater here in Anchorage. For Mr. Josh Lowman.
My name is Josh Lowman. I'm the Anchorage General Manager for Perseverance Theater. We really enjoyed working on this. We really do help bring up new artists. We really want to see what our Alaskans have to say. Our mission is theater for and by Alaskans, and this is part of that. Another part of that is next year, a brand new play we're going to be doing by an amazing Alaskan playwright named Vera Starbard. It's called, why did I just blank on this? Oh my God. Our voices will be heard. She's right here. Call Our Voices Will Be Heard. It's an amazing story of mother-daughter relationship, stopping the cycle of violence. It's something everyone should come see next year. It's going to be happening in February here in Anchorage, January down to Juneau. That's next season. This season, we've got Odd Couple running. This is the set for Odd Couple, minus the set parts.
Yeah, they moved out when we moved in.
Yeah. Kind of move them all out of the apartment. Aside from that, other things we kind of have going on, we've got a travel raffle happening, so if you want to buy a raffle ticket, they're $10 and the prizes are all amazing. Top prize is $2,000, two tickets anywhere in the world Alaska Airlines flies, and a two-night stay at the Hotel Beacon if you happen to decide to go to New York. So that's a few of the things that we've got going on. I'm passing it back now.
Passing it back. All right, so it's important to note that tonight we are streaming live on the internet, hello viewers, via our partners at HowlRound TV. You can find the archive of tonight's performance at HowlRound.tv. It'll be available immediately following tonight's performance. It is free. It will live online forever as an archive and sort of an artifact of what we accomplished here as a community together. You can also follow the conversation about the One Minute Play Festival on Twitter and Facebook with the hashtag 1MPF. And you can visit our website, oneminuteplayfestivalspelledout.com, to see all of our 24 national partnerships this year. We're going to stop talking now. Here's the second annual Alaska One Minute Play Festival.
So, where are all these moose?
Well, if you look real close in between the trees.
You know what I think? It's an urban legend.
Well, that's not really
yeah,
true.
No, it's just a big fat lie to entice tourists. Unless they're like those comic book moose, you know, the ones that squeeze their whole bodies behind those little comic book trees to spread. Oh, I like these. Hey, why don't you take a picture of me in front of this tree right here?
okay, sure. Cheese.
Cheese. Alright. Hey, you know what? I think I'm gonna go downtown and take a picture in front of those bronze moose statues. This is probably the closest thing I'm gonna get to the real thing. Come on, Harry.
Okay, well, if you turn around real slow right now,
I can't see. The sun's about to set.
Well, okay, sure.
Hey, Pops, you weren't gone long. How'd you do?
Some asshole set off all my traps. Left a shitload of bees in them.
Oh, yeah? I didn't know you were hunting for My Little Ponies. What'd you bait it with? Rainbows?
Shut that smart mouth. I find the song that
this isn't too tore up. I could fix it up and give it to Brittany. She's been real tore up ever since Trooper died. She was nuts about that dog.
Forget about that girl. She's a goddamn tree hugger. Don't they know that triggering illegal traps a crime?
Yeah, but I told you, and I told you, you set them too close to the trails.
I don't put them no place they ain't legal.
Yeah, but kids and dogs like to wander. When that coney bear broke Trooper's back, Britt was real tore up about it, and you know how I feel about it, Pops.
What you saying, boy?
You ever check eBay? They got some great deals on some stuffed animals.
Yeah, I don't care how you get them in the crate, just do it. I don't know, throw some steak in there or something. How you gonna escape them? Be fast, real fast. Listen, I want those doggies down here pronto at midnight. Yeah, that same guy that sleeps on the courthouse steps, we get here before the cops kick him off, get to watch them devour him. Bring a camera. Yeah, thanks.
Hey, I couldn't help but overhear your conversation.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, it was a very peculiar conversation. So you're planning on releasing some wild dogs on someone downtown tonight?
No dogs, no.
Oh, okay, that's what I thought I heard.
They're wolves.
Excuse me?
Yeah, they're wolves. We're reintroducing wolves to downtown to clear out the homeless problem.
I'll give you 5 seconds to leave before I shoot you in the foot. Then I'll force pepper spray into both of your eyes, point blank!
Oh.
What took you so long? I told my folks you'd landed. They can't wait to meet my young man from the East Coast.
Moose!
In the arts? Oh, shoot, it's gone.
Well, I was just grabbing my bag from the car and it huge red eye flopping out the mouth. What kind of place is this that I was grabbing moose?
Well, it's Alaska, and the moose wasn't rabid. Did it charge you?
It didn't have to. Look, this is a bad idea. I need to go home.
Well, there's a lot worse in Manhattan. Like muggers.
I'll take a mugger over a rabid moose any day. Call it an epiphany, but I'm catching the first flight out of here.
I don't believe this. What about us? What about our future?
You could go to New York. With me. Or not. I'll call a cab.
Don't bother. I'll drive you back to the airport.
Solid.
Here, Lucy, Lucy.
It's in there.
The vermin's in our bedroom, but your trap got it.
Yes.
Well, at least it went out peaceful. Not what?
Not went out.
What, the copper didn't scream?
The thing is really, really big.
Well, go finish the chore. It's after 11. I gotta work in the morning.
Escape!
You let it get away?
There was blood all over the floorboards.
And did you find it?
Her. She was cowering under the dresser.
I don't care. Go get her out of here. My back can't stand sleeping on this couch all night long.
Oh, but I think she might be in labor. Her eyes, they were just so sad.
Fine. We'll stay out here tonight. As long as you're happy. Are you happy, Angela? Are you? Are you?
Congratulations, you bastard! You convinced an entire class of students to have sex for the camera!
On the floor of a reptile laboratory. Oh, it's fascinating.
In the name of scientific research!
Oh, will it pass the Regents?
It's science!
Right, I didn't realize that having an orgy on the lab floor was science.
Look, see the snakes? They're watching the students. Their eyes are shining. Those snakes are turned on!
That's nuts!
Snakes are very shy. Zoologists have never seen them mate.
Sadly true.
Until now, when people slither around the floor in front of snakes, something trickles here. In their reptile brain, these snakes are horny.
Oh my God! Look at them.
If snakes could see people fornicating on a wet tile floor, we figured they would want to do it too. Be old!
Hey, can I get a copy of this video?
Why?
Because my pet turtles are sluggish and I thought maybe this would come to my mind.
Part right.
I lied, but you're a shit zoo.
All right, guys, here's another one.
Can we guess your level of education?
Did it? I got masters.
So what does that mean?
What the hell? Stupid game anyways.
Yeah, they're all stupid.
Idiotic.
Like, I'm really a blue person. I think I'm more chartreuse. But that wasn't one of the colors. I think this is rigged.
Shut up.
Yeah, just shut up. So, Emily, who did say why was I born with such contemporaries?
Oscar Wilde.
Who the fuck is Oscar Wilde?
As I was driving to work this morning, my husband tells me that he got an email from this woman who says that she is his daughter.
Wait, what daughter?
That's what I said, along with some other choice words I won't repeat. She put out one of those Facebook ads, you know, where they hold up a sign that says, my name is blah, 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 and I am looking for my family.
I always feel bad for those people and hit share.
So did I, until it happened to my family. Our children saw it. Our children saw it before my husband or myself did. Everyone we know saw it before we did.
I'm not sure what to say.
Neither do I.
What do you say to someone you're suddenly related to who is an adult? How do you explain to everyone you know something that is private?
Maybe you could hold up a sign and put it on Facebook? Social media is getting on my nerves.
I love social media. If I didn't have social media, I don't think I'd socialize with people, period.
It's just all these requests for prayer. Please pray for me, I have a job interview. Please pray for me, I have a cold and my nose is running. It used to be that we only gave prayers to those who really needed prayers.
Prayers are like money in the bank of God. You can't just spend it on frivolous stuff.
My point exactly. What if I use up my allotment on your cousin who has diarrhea, and then my husband gets cancer and we're screwed in the grand scheme of things?
Just say positive things with a hashtag in front of them. Hashtag saving my prayers for better things, or hashtag sorry, better luck next time, or hashtag buy Pepto Bismol, it'll make you feel better.
Have I mentioned that hashtags are getting on my nerves?
This conversation is getting on my nerves.
Feed the humans and give them air, oxygen, etc. So isn't it a zero-sum game? How did the machines get energy from them?
Sir, why are you telling me this?
Well, I saw your sign on the freeway, plot hole hotline, and I thought I'd give a call.
Potholes,
Oh. Sorry.
You ever think about that?
are you going to do in school today?
Well, something learned about the Revolution War. And then in math, we learned about fractions. And then in science, we learned about cells. And then in English, we're printing a Broadway.
Oh, would you look at the time? Don't you have a bunch of slick guests or anything?
Maybe about 15 minutes or so.
Well, it sounds like you have a particularly busy day. I have a feeling you should be prepared and go early.
You really think so?
Listen to your mother.
Love you too, sweetheart.
So, do you want to have sex now or later?
Now, and then again later. Just don't give me another one of those.
I love how there's still school on Veterans Day.
Oh, look, another show on TV in Alaska.
Lame.
Oh, this one is about the homesteaders.
Oh, another show about Alaska.
Dude, this guy's in deerskins running around on the tundra. Awesome.
It's all just exaggerated bullshit. They hit it with melodramatic music. Why do you even watch that crap anyway?
Whatever. You watch a stupid show with the zombies.
Hey, that show is cool.
Lame.
If we don't catch any fish today, we may not eat for 3 months. Wah!
This show will probably be over in 3 months. Hey, Game of Thrones is on pretty soon. Have you seen a new commercial?
Really? Cool! You know, those White Walkers are a lot like zombies.
Lame. You're a zombie.
Here we are, gentlemen. Are we celebrating anything special this evening?
No.
Yes.
No!
your maid will be right with you.
What?
It's official.
Oh my God, would you stop? We did paperwork.
Sounds so romantic when you put it that way. Come on, we're to celebrate.
We already did that.
When?
3 years ago.
That was different.
How was it different? It was a wedding, wasn't it?
See this marriage license? This is an Alaskan license. It's real now.
And it wasn't real what we did 3 years ago. There was a DJ. I remember paying $2,000 to a photographer, which is about $14,000 wedding. 80 people grabbed hands and wished us well. You know, after 13 years, I am sick and tired of reconceptualizing our relationship every time there's a vote or a court case or someone that's actually involved in our family that's okay with us holding hands and kissing.
You really know how to sweet talk a girl.
But aren't you excited? We're going to Anchorage, Alaska.
I live there. I'll be glad to get home, but...
Oh, man, you live there? That would be my dream! What's it like?
Is it as amazing as Daly's Catch? I've been saving up for 2 years to take this trip.
Oh, really? Why?
Are you kidding me? I've been waiting to ski my whole life. I've got new skis, new snow pants. I've even got new goggles. I can't wait to land, head to the top of the slope, and feel that white powder underneath my skis.
Oh, wow. Have you been watching the weather reports this winter?
Man, have I? Blizzards shutting down whole towns on the East Coast? Crazy snow in places like Texas? Which doesn't usually get it. I can't even imagine how much snow Alaska must have. Once I saw all the reports about the blizzards, I sold my car to finally get to Alaska.
Oh, dear. I don't know how to tell you this.
What would you like to watch?
I don't care. You pick. You don't like any of my TV shows anyway. Why do you even watch it?
I don't know. I just like it.
Why do they even try to make it look all dramatic? Seriously, how many times can a piece of heavy machinery break in one day?
You can watch something else if you want to.
Oh my God, did they find any gold this time? They dug up all that land, and they haven't found any gold.
Uh-huh.
Alaskans don't even look like that. I can't stand these Alaskan reality TV shows. Why do you like the show so much?
I guess I like it because it reminds me of my dad. Do you still want to watch something else?
No. Once into the breach, Simon, once into the breach. And when the blast of war blows in our ears, then let us imitate the action of the tiger. Yes.
Does it have to be a tiger? They have archers. A tiger can't hold a shield.
He's right. No thumbs, tigers.
It's a metaphor, like a tiger.
Simile.
Simile.
Then lend the eye a terrible aspect.
Apologies, Zionists. They done poked me in the eye with one of their long spears.
Albert.
Right, Albert. I don't think I can do all what you just said.
Dishonor not your mothers. Now attest that those you call fathers did beget me.
About that, me lord. Me mom makes eyes at the baker every now and then.
We happy few be band of brothers, for he who sheds his blood with me this day shall be my brother. I had a brother once. He died right over there. Boil and oil melt to the spice. Clean up.
I saw him there, I did. Running about in
the I? Fuck it. Run away to England.
Saying you're going to have to learn to do without your regular check.
What do you mean, do without it? It's mine.
You need to face reality. You're not in good financial shape.
But it's my fun money, my Hawaii trip, my spa treatment, and I donate some of it to charity.
Well?
Some is better than none.
$25?
Is better than not $25.
I suppose.
It's my fur coat, my massage chair, my new rifle. Do you hate the Second Amendment?
What's that got to do with it?
I mean, if you would just try a little harder, you'd see I'm bolstering the economy.
Okay, do you want a fur coat, or do you want to have the schools open?
Both.
Well, we're out of money. So you can either go on getting a $2,000 check from a fund that you did nothing to earn, or do like everybody else in America and go without it.
You will have to pry my permanent fund check from my cold, dead hands!
What are you working on?
Writing a play. That's what I do in my breaks.
What do you mean, a play?
You know, like for a theater show.
Oh, a play.
What's wrong with that?
I'll tell you what's wrong with it, you metrosexual urban waste of life. You've forgotten what the real struggle is. Men used to hunt, and survive, and battle! And now they write theater garbage with their baby soft hands all the while, smelling like a French woman.
Dude, shut up. You aren't from Talkeetna, you went to school at Diamond. Your mom used to baby you when you got those nosebleeds while everybody laughed. Your middle name is Pons.
Hello?
Hello, this is Catherine Hamilton.
Oh, yes. Yeah, my daughter said you'd be calling.
Yes, I appreciate your time.
Anything for my daughter.
Of course. And to that point, about your daughter.
She said that you were interested in hiring her as your nanny, but you needed a mother's personal review first.
Yes, I am. It is a big commitment.
She'll be living with you?
Oh, no. 30 to 50 hours a week. We have two, and we're working on one more. She would accompany us to Mexico on vacation for 2 weeks a year. We also have a free benefits package, as well as 2 weeks paid vacation, and a college incentive to learn Spanish.
Wow, that sounds terrific.
Yes, very fair.
Very, yes.
So what would you say is your daughter's best attribute?
Oh, she cares too much.
Really?
And her greatest weakness? She cares too much.
Best job ever.
Thank you.
I...
Don't say it!
I love...
Don't say it!
I love...
Don't
I love
say it. It!
I love you.
You said it.
I did.
Excuse me, sir. Do you have a few dollars?
What do you want the money for, young man?
It's cold out. I'd just like a cup of coffee to warm myself up.
Sure. Do me a favor, though, will you? Bring me back the change.
Thank you, sir. I'll do that.
Did that guy just come in here and bum $5 off of you? I hate that! Coming in here off the street and bothering you like that. Look, I can call my boss over here, man.
He didn't bum the money off of me. I wanted to buy the young man a cup of coffee. He wasn't disturbing me, but you are.
Here's your change, sir.
Did you leave a tip?
No, sir. The girl's kind of rude.
Do me another favor, will you? You keep the change. I'd rather you have it than them.
Thank you, sir. You have a nice day.
You have to take that job. We need the money coming in now.
It's a shitty job, and I am not selling my soul to pay for your extravagance.
Extravagances? These are bills here. Upkeep, transportation, education for our kids.
Well, we have to learn to cut back. Kids don't need the computer, and we can take the bus, or better yet, walk.
This is Alaska. It's cold out there. You want me to walk?
I want you to color your own hair. You don't need to go to the most expensive salon in the city.
You want me to color my own hair? I never thought it would come to this.
Well, we're out of money.
Well, there's ways to come up with the money. We have to get creative about finding the money at the same time we're making cuts. There's just some things you don't do without. We could dip into our savings. And there's always...
We're not using our PFD.
Okay. Okay. I'll color my own hair. If you'll stop drinking beer.
Crap. I'll take the shitty job.
Okay.
Okay.
I'm ready to sign.
Fantastic. You won't regret it.
You got me.
Thank you.
Nailed it.
You drive a hard bargain.
I try.
You squeeze that deal dry.
But you close the deal and I'm not easy. You're good too.
Let me let you in on a secret. I'm actually on probation here. Haven't sold shit all year. If I didn't close you today, they were going to fire me.
Really?
You saved my ass. So I'm going to take another $1,000 off the deal.
I thought I squeezed it dry.
Oh, out of my commission, I mean.
Why would you do that?
To celebrate.
Hey,
you got a problem with free money? Make it $1,200.
I gotta think about it.
Thank you for saving my ass! $1,500!
I'm not ready.
For what?
Let me think about it.
Think about it.
Later. Next week, baby.
Oh, get you so ready to sign.
Don't call me. I'll call you.
Pot dealers.
The pot dealer is local 27.
Stop thinking of the children!
I gotta go. Yes, children!
Children!
From Foxborough Park, I'm Tracy Chandler.
You? I sold meth and heroin out of a nail salon in Berlin.
That's okay, man. Kind of cool. Hey, how about you?
I tried to kill a VPSO with a screwdriver.
Yeah, a fist bump.
You?
Yeah, I stabbed a guy in the eye at the tavern because he was looking at my old lady.
Fuck, gotta do the same thing. How about you? Yo! I said, how about you?
Me?
Yeah, what'd you do, man?
My wife and I started a floating strip club off of Kodiak.
Oh shit, that's badass!
With your wife? Man, never let go of her!
Wait, that shit's illegal, man?
It is, when you dump human waste from the boat to the harbor.
Hey, get me out of here! I'm off your head! It's organic!
Thanks for coming, everybody. I know there's a lot going on in town today, so I'm glad you showed up here. I want to be your next mayor.
Hello!
No, it's been a real time of reflection for me. Am I worthy? Should I even aspire to be the mayor?
You tell him, baby.
I'll tell you what. I love to hunt. And I love to drink beer. And it's been 5 months since the last time I forced my way into the driver's seat while I was wasted. I think that's pretty good.
Yeah, and I am telling you that is the truth. Joe, he believes in your freedom, but he doesn't need some fancy high school diploma to know what's right.
How about you? A vote for me? That's a vote for yourself.
Mm-hmm. And who better leading you than yourself?
Only I'll do all the actual work. You get the government you deserve.
Class, open your books to page 25. We'll start with problem 3. Take your seat, Jacob. We just got started. Jacob, honey, what's the matter? Class, everyone get under your desks. Jacob, honey, I know you've had a hard time.
I want to die, and I want everyone to die with me.
I understand how you feel, baby. I felt like killing myself before. When I got a divorce, I know how bad you feel. Jacob, baby, you know you need help, don't you?
I want to do it.
Baby, we're not going to hate you. It's going to be all right, sweetheart. I just want you to know that I love you, baby, okay? Are you all set?
Yes. Wow. Okay. Do it again.
Are you sure?
Do it again. 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 Oh. Where are you going? Don't leave.
I can't.
I'm ready. Do it.
Just wish I knew why she disappeared. I mean, I knew she was on drugs, but I thought she was getting help.
When the coroner asked me to identify her from the pictures, I just saw her laying in the street like that.
Her nose looks thinner. It must be all that embalming you're doing.
Well, ready to go?
What are you two doing?
Wait, I thought...
That's not me! I'm not dead! I went to rehab!
Yeah, that's a pain.
I get stamps online. It's cheaper.
Oh.
Never type a password. Hackers record keystrokes.
for the tip.
I've got a killer migraine, and I'm anemic. Doctor says it's hormones.
Try iron pills.
My best friend was found dead in a park. We both pole danced together at the Wild Pony.
I'm sorry.
My boyfriend dated her. She was a better dancer, but I'm better at...
Cut, husband's calling.
She gave him BD, and he gave it to me, and now she's dead.
Dead? With BD? With pipe? Honey?
Where's my meds? I thought about a nervous breakdown. Remember what I said about hackers?
Hackers, not hookers. Wait, you recognize her voice from where? When were you at the Wild Pony?
You know, I've been doing a lot of thinking lately.
Yeah.
Vroom. And the world's a pretty messed up place in this particular day and age. I mean, I'm talking like Ferguson and police billy clubbing old men. It's like 85 police related deaths in the last month. That's outrageous in our society. And criminals are still breaking into people's homes. That is 100% all organic foobar. And I'm talking fucking politicians, Wall Street cooking us dry, and like I'm talking about like
slow down.
Russia and ISIS and North Korean haircuts. You seen the North Korean haircuts, man? And I'm talking like cat videos and selfies and commercialism and hey, FEMA my Mega Man video.
Is it really worth speaking about?
No, well, guys, I'm talking like the ozone and the plasma and everything.
Thank you.
was awesome. Can you believe that we just elected an Alaska Native Lieutenant Governor? It's a good day to be Native.
Are you kidding? We could have had an Alaska Native Governor. Why should we be happy about second place? It is a low day to be Native.
Did you see their joint announcements on Facebook? Native people being placed in higher positions to promote a better understanding of our people. It is a great day to be Native.
Okay, but did you see the ugly, ignorant comments under those Facebook announcements? It's a sad day to be Native.
Okay, Negative Nancy. Did you see the inauguration ceremony? Native people dancing, Lieutenant Governor getting down in his Tlingit regalia. It is an awesome day to be Native.
Okay, I saw Tlingit dancing, but what about you, Victor Athabaskan or Inupiaq? It's a tough day to be any other kind of Native.
Well, yeah, yeah, but we have to get to the inauguration dinner. Did you see that they're serving fry bread and blueberry agate?
It's a good day to be Native.
Stronger, you'll live longer, and this is that moment.
where you make it all possible. Please.
Okay, I'll try it. I do enjoy it.
Moonlight.
Anger.
New shoes.
Tits on the moon!
You, inside of yourself.
I'm feeling a bit peckish. Are you feeling peckish?
I gave that up a long time ago.
Hey, when did we land on the moon?
We didn't.
I mean they. When did they land on the moon?
They didn't. Never happened. Just one of those fictions they like us to believe.
Mm, like me? Like me to you?
Like people with each other.
You know, my food allergies aren't fictitious.
No, they're very real. Could I cook you something? An egg?
Eggs on the moon? You know, I don't care if it's not true.
Makes no difference to me.
Mm. Hey, did you ever find the flyers?
We don't need them anymore. So, over easy?
You know me. Always sunny side up.
Look, son, it's the Pacific Ocean.
It's really blue.
Oh, look, dear, the Atlantic.
It's so green.
In just a few minutes, we will be landing at the Sea of Tranquility. Ground temperature is a balmy 200 degrees Fahrenheit. Those of you continuing on your flight with us, please stay on the craft. We will be departing in just 30 minutes. If this is your final destination, please check your seating area for your personal items before deplaning. Thank you for flying Virgin Galactic.
Dad, will we get to see Grandpa?
And Grandma?
Now, a moment of silence to remember all of those who sacrificed their lives for space travel.
Blah, blah.
You know, Archie, we are real tired of you. Peeing on the bathroom rug and pooping up out of your pee box. Betty Rose is old and we're really tired of you chasing her around the house. Oh, when the two of you flew through my bedroom last night, they made me let me mommy with a capital M, a big old bye-bye. Ring walk and eating both of the parents'
lives.
People thought Daddy had beat on me. Can you imagine Daddy beating on me? Oh, when you threw in there with your 20-pound belly and your long white teeth and the big black heart mark on your butt, you definitely told me to have your travel. I know. But the second I do, you're going to take off my hand. Red ass bed. Red cat. Red ass bed.
Old. I mean, that's 60.
Blah, blah.
What's wrong?
Nothing!
Please tell me what's the matter!
Oh, what's the...
Oboe?
Oboe.
Hobo.
They told you I'd teach you, and you've never heard of Joseph Sook.
I'm sorry.
How about Ostrich?
The name sounds familiar.
No, it isn't. Grumia.
No.
Sir. Megalyn.
Baby.
Why should I bother? You've never heard of anybody. Why should I bother to teach you?
I'm good.
All grad students are good. Have you ever heard of Hyphus?
Yes.
Down pressure.
That's how we got that tearful, tragic sound. When I heard your audition tape, I thought this one needs more hyphens. Get out your bow. Let me show you how he holds his, so you can try it.
Wow!
I had dinner with him once, after he played the Sibelius in New York.
What a concert!
You went out with him?
And a pack of admirers.
Still. And that man can tell a joke. Outrageous. Now, get out your bow.
We're going to fix it.
Vote for me!